Welcome to 50 and 50 to 50. My name is Doug Fitzgerald. If we don't know each other, I want to say hello. It's great to meet you, and I'm so glad that you're here. The reason why I'm here is I've accepted a challenge from my son, who's 22, and he's like, Dad, you know, you need to get into social media on a daily basis, posting and providing content. And as a guy pushing toward his 50th birthday, that's not the easiest thing for me to do. So I'm going to be modeling something that my dear friend Tracy Morrow has been doing. She's been doing 50 episodes in 50 weeks, one a week, leading up to her 50th birthday. I'm going to try something. I'm going to do my best to do 50 episodes in 50 days leading up to my 50th birthday. So you're probably saying, well, what in the world are you going to share? And why would I want to tune in to these episodes every day? Well, I'm going to share some just stories, life lessons I've learned along the way. I'm going to have a lot of tips and fun. And I'm hoping that it'll add value to your life. And at the same time, we'll get to know each other. And always feel free to reach out, post, message me, like these videos. I'd really appreciate that as well. So for today, for my very first episode, my title is, How Do You Spend Your Time? Pretty simple. How do you spend your time? My 50th birthday is coming up in 50 days. And I've done a lot of reflecting over this past year of how fast time flies. It goes by so fast. And I know my parents and my grandparents would always tell me, you know, Doug, time goes by really fast. So take advantage of the moments that you have. And you hear that and you kind of understand it, but it kind of goes in one ear and out the other until all of a sudden you wake up one day and you go, oh my goodness, like in a year I'm going to be 50. And what does that mean? You know, I was born in the late 60s. So I grew up in the 70s and 80s. And I started thinking about all the changes that have happened over the last 50 years, and they've been pretty crazy. See, I grew up when you had a TV set that weighed about 200 pounds, and you had to get up every time you wanted to change a channel and go to it and click it. And then we had these ancient remotes where they're big old boxes, and you click it, and they literally would click, 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 and they would turn the channel. And then eventually we got, you know, TVs and then HD TVs, and now, you know, you can get on our phones and you just watch TV. It's crazy. Think about cable. Back then, we only had three channels that we could watch. And I remember how huge it was. I believe I was in junior high when we got cable. We finally got cable and we could watch all these different channels. And nowadays, you know, we have YouTube TV is what we have. And it's amazing. You can watch it anywhere you go. Watch any channel that you want, not including all the movie channels and Netflixes and Hulus and all that stuff now. It's just astounding. How about telephones? I grew up when you had a telephone on the wall, and it had a cord, and it was attached, and you could only talk on a telephone as long as the cord was, and you had to hold up. You had to rotary dial it, and then it was really a big deal to get punch buttons and then to get digital phones. Crazy. Nowadays, I was digging through some stuff the other day, some old boxes, and I came across my very first iPhone. Get this, very first iPhone. And now I think, 10 plus years later or so, you know, here's my iPhone 10X or XS or whatever it is, plus. There's more computing power in these, than there probably was in the very first supercomputers that weighed tons and took up rooms. Just how fast technology has changed. How about cash? Man, I tell you what, when I was young, all you could do was spend what you had, cash. We didn't have all these different kinds of credit cards. The first thing I remember was there like a Diners Club or like American Express, and that was it. And you had to pay it off every month. Like, you couldn't extend it. Now we live in a digital society that you use your phones to, you know, I use my phone to order my Paneras and my Panera lunches, and everything's digital, and all the purchasing goes through the air somehow, and they get it, and I'm able to just drive and pick it up and head home and eat my salad or whatever. So cash is so different nowadays. It's all digital. How about class reunions? Oh my goodness, you think about when you first started school or preschool and how little you were and the pictures there are, and then you grow up over the years. And this last year, my class was celebrating their 32nd class reunion. How crazy is that? I graduated in 1987. So I was thinking earlier today, what about workouts and weight loss? I remember my mom doing Jack LaLanne. I don't know about you, but chairs and books, and that was kind of the weights and stuff. And then every once in a while, I'd hear them do something like the Dolly Parton diet, where basically they ate cabbage soup or something. And then Suzanne Summers had the Thigh Masters. And now we've got workout clubs literally on about every corner in the city. And you can get online and you can stream your workouts, and it's just crazy how that's all changed. Last thing I want to share about, just in reminiscing, what about video games? The very first video game I remember was a video game called Blip. And literally it was, I think there were like three buttons on each side of this box. And it was this little, I think it was red, this little red light that would go back and forth, and you had to guess which box it was going to land in, and you had a partner you played against. Then we had a little red box thing called Merlin, and then we had Simon, and then the old electronic football games, and then we progressed to Atari, where you could actually buy games and put it in the system and play them on TV, and then it has progressed. I mean, now, like I said, you can play anything you want to on your phones, computers, or whatever. But my whole point being this, time goes by so fast and things change so fast. That's why it's important to really contemplate your life. It's important. My thought today is very simple. Life is short, so let's make every day count. You know, that's one of the reasons why a few years ago I wrote my book, which actually was released by my publisher, Morgan James Publishing, last fall, September 18th of 2018, called One Shot, One Life. And in it, I share the principles I've learned over the years to have ultimate success in every area of my life. And I teach those five powerful principles. And so if you want to learn about the book, you can get it on Amazon.com or anywhere fine books are sold. Or you can go to our website too at oneshotonelife.com. But what I've been doing over the past year is generating resources for people. And one of the things that I put together is a personal mastermind group of 10 people. And the first thing I had these 10 people do in our very first meeting was create their One Shot, One Life eulogy. I had them write out, what would your eulogy read if you were to die today? What would you want it to read? Ultimately, what would you like to have people remember about you? And the interesting thing about doing that, everybody's perspective changed really quick about what was really important in life and what they wanted to change and the priorities that they wanted to accomplish to get done, so that when they finished their life, they could say they finished it well. So how are you spending your time? I'll close out with the question I had at the beginning of the episode. How are you spending your time? I hope you're spending it well. Thank you so much for joining me for this first episode. I'm really excited to share with you over the next 50 days. Again, I'm Doug Fitzgerald. And remember, you only have one shot at your amazing one life. So make every single day count. We'll see you next time. I will not waste my life watching the world.